Welcome back, everyone, and it's that time of month we get to look at all the cool new stuff we're going to be seeing on the workshop. First up on the bench, longtime sponsor Model Roundup, newer sponsor MRC has sent over some kits, so we'll take a look at those and see what we're going to be building up on the show. We've got available at Model Roundup right now Salvinos JR models, 1/25th scale. This means that it is one of Salvinos' designs. The 1/24th scales that they release are the monogram models that they're reissuing. We've got Richard Petty's 1980 Chevy Monte Carlo. It means the season or race he ran the car in. Doesn't always mean the exact year of that body. That's how they brand their boxes. This is the reverse Monte Carlo, the one where he ran the vermilion and then the blue. Instead of the blue mane and the vermilion over it, it's when he ran the reverse scheme, and it is pretty cool looking. So these kits always build up nice. ModelRoundup.com will have this for your purchasing pleasure. And as well, from Model Roundup, you can expect to see a full build of this kit coming up sooner than you might think. It is Roden's brand new 1/35th scale 1947 silver side bus. This is the iconic cross-country Greyhound bus. These things are epic. They are well known. They've got that gorgeous three-tone. We got the metallic, the light blue, and the white top on them. This is an extensive, extensive builder's kit. You're going to need some experience to build this. It is not a beginner's kit, but it is definitely worth picking up. Roden is a company from the Ukraine. We also see other companies like ICM from Ukraine. I expect good things from this kit. I've looked at it inside. It is absolutely gorgeous. It is recommended for 14 and up only because of the experience level and the number of parts and the number of windows and everything else that's in this, plus the more complex paint job. So I'll be working on that. ModelRoundup.com has this in stock right now. So if you want it, if you want to watch me build it up on the show, I would recommend getting it. These are in very limited production. So if someone has it available, Model Roundup has it, grab it now, because you never know when you're going to see it again. And then from the folks at MRC, they are starting to carry the Trumpeter line, and they have this kit available. This was so cool that I asked for it. They had also sent the Italeri Jeep that I had just built, and this one is the U.S. Navy Landing Craft Air Cushion, or as everyone else would just call it, a hovercraft, in 1/144th scale. This is the big honking hovercraft, not the one or two guy units, but the massive ones. Now, you can see by the size of the box in this scale, it's not all that big, but it has 230 parts in this little tiny box, including a full rubber skirt. It is the Marine Landing Craft one, so we're going to be checking this bad boy out and building it up. I'm going to get the next sponsor out. While you're thinking about that, we'll see you in just a second. These kits right here are available from our folks at ICM at this exact moment. ICM out of the Ukraine sent over these model kits. You can check them out. They are available right now, so we'll go over it, and I'll give you the numbers where you can order these from your hobby shop, order them online, or your favorite retailer. First up, 1/35th scale, kit number 35606, the Model T 1914 fire truck with crew. So we've seen the fire truck before. Now they're doing what they love to do, where they give you the figures inside. All right, complex kit, but it builds absolutely beautiful. You've seen me build their Model T's before. They are absolutely exquisite. They go together beautifully, and now you can do it with the period correct 1914 fire crew. Kit number 35606. Next up from ICM is the G7117 with World War II Soviet drivers. So this one, we've seen this kit before. They released the utility vehicle, the Lend-Lease program, and now they've got it with the drivers inside. So you get those sweet, sweet ICM figure kits with that awesome Soviet utility truck. They're deuce and a half, we'll call it. That is kit number 35594, 1/35th scale, like most of their land vehicles. Kit number 35594 available right now. Also in that scale, rounding it out, is this very unique looking, the Lafley V15T. It's a French artillery towing vehicle. Look at this thing. It's like a Jeep with like a smaller Jeep front end attached. It's really, really different looking. And I think people would get a kick out of building something so unique. 35570 is the kit number, 1/35th scale. That thing is just so, so cool looking. So I might have to set that aside for a full build at some point and weather it up and whatnot. Now, in the much bigger size, 1/35th scale, much more modern, is kit number 35002, the Soviet six-wheel army truck with shelter. That is a lot. 1/35th scale on there. Check that sweet box art out. This thing is a beast. I've actually seen something like this on a YouTube series called World's Most Dangerous Roads. Really cool documentary, not fake reality. It's a real show. They end up taking vehicles all across the world's worst roads and driving them through. This one's got the shelter in the back so you could stay warm and do some surgery back there, working, cleaning weapons and all that stuff. This is a huge kit, big vehicle. We've got three different schemes in the box. Kit number 35002 available right now from ICM. And next on the table is this really big box set. We're talking a lot of stuff in this box. It is the Vietnam United States Air Force Airfield. Okay, it's gonna have the Broncos in it. It is a sweet, sweet kit. All right, 1/48th scale, kit number DS4803. What I wanna do is read on the side here, all right, and it tells you it's got the Cessna 02A, it's got the OV-10A Bronco, and it's got the ground crew, all right? It's got the full ground crew. I love him with his American flag helmet on there. Check out that box art. You're gonna get everything on the front, except, of course, for the tarmac in the box. Kit number DS4803, 1/48th scale, which is known as quarter scale, which means every quarter inch of the model is a foot in real life. These are both gorgeous kits. Now you can get them together with the figures. You can make a base. You've got a diorama in a box. I'm going to set up the next sponsor and I'll be right back. Next up is a little bit of a combination. Fanhome is still sending over all the cool parts for that massive 1/8th scale charger. I wait till I have two boxes. Each box has four issues in it. You'll get one of these a month. So I like to do two full boxes, we'll do eight issues in one video, and we can get through the video without having to put, you know, issue six, in all individual videos. I like doing more of a longer video and letting you see more of the build process. So as soon as I get another box from Fanhome, we'll be doing another 69 Charger from Fast and Furious build-up video. Personal stash time of the month. Every single month I get stuff for myself. And we're also gonna be doing some reviews on the side of models here. We're also gonna be doing some reviews of some aquariums that I've bought recently. I love aquariums, I love to decorate. I don't have anything on the screen because I can't fit 45 gallon aquariums onto the screen, but I know a lot of you like doing that, and if you don't like it, you don't have to watch those reviews, but I enjoy them. So I will be also reviewing some aquariums that I've purchased and decorating them and all that stuff on the channel just for fun, because the workshop is not just plastic models. It's anything that this guy running the camera thinks is cool. So from Italeri, I picked up some stuff on my own stash supply, and some of this stuff we'll be seeing on the show. I just don't know when. First up, I got some great deals on some clearance merchandise, the Italeri racing trailer. Find this at retailers like modelroundup.com. It's kit number 3936. It's in 1/24th scale. It is a really cool automotive racing trailer, all enclosed trailer. And it does actually include the ginormous water slides to create that look for it. So I'm excited about that one. It shows you all the decals that are in the box. And from what I built other Italeri truck kits and trailer kits, and they went together very nicely. So I've got high hopes for this stuff, and that's why I picked it up. Plus the box weighs like 4 pounds of plastic in it. And I heard from other viewers, I do read the comments on the other truck reviews, and every review I do, I read the comments. Even if I don't have time to reply to 700 comments on a video, I do read them. And more than one of you said, Chris, if you get the chance, pick up Italeri's Volvo VN780. It's kit number 3892, 1/24th scale. They said it is a very nice big rig kit. It's got the extra big sleeper. It's got this really cool stars and metallic jagged stripe decal kit in it. It's got chrome parts, wheels. It's a dressed out over the road truck. I love the blue grill on this one and all that stuff. So when I had the chance to pick it up, I did. It's also got other kinds of graphics in the box for different types of decoration on there, and it's got the cool box art on there. So I thought that would be good to team up with that race trailer that I just took off the screen. So I snatched that up when I was able to nag it at a clearance price, and at a clearance price on a website, I was able to find Italeri Zundapp KS750 with sidecar. I have the BMW with sidecar, and it's a beautiful kit. And I've built the Kettenkrod and the WLA, the Harley, the World War II motorcycle. So adding this to the collection was an absolute no-brainer. I had to do it. It's kit number 7406. It's got the German markings in it. It is a really cool ninth scale. Ninth scale means the tires are going to be like this big. So awesome kit if you can get it at a great price. Got a ton of color schemes. Not only does it have the gray, but it's got the camo, it's got the desert yellow, and all kinds of decals for different units and decorations. One of my favorite things on these motorcycles is on the fenders. They have that license plate on there. I just love that. This one's got a machine gun, giant spare tires. So you get two big tires, you get the one up there, you got the ammo boxes. Much, much too cool. I'm gonna reset for the next sponsor, and I'll be right back. One of our longest sponsors on the channel have been the amazing folks at Round 2 Models, and they are not stopping for 2022. They are kicking it into overdrive. They've got all kinds of cool stuff coming out. You know, you saw me build the Star Wars stuff is coming back. They've got new and reissued Star Trek things. They've got Space 1999. They've got model cars being improved and redesigned and reissued, and they're coming up with new designs. We got a garbage truck coming from Round 2. But for right now, here's what we have sent over. We're going to be taking a look at the Chevy custom van. The Foxy Box is going to be back in production. Now, most of these kits on the screen right now aren't available at this exact second. These are from the orders. When they get these in, they'll get a box of like 12 kits to make sure the production run is going to be perfect, and then they tell that to assemble that for the production run. So these are production kits. This is what they're going to look like. It's just that they get about a dozen in advance, and I'm very fortunate in that I build them for the show quickly. So they send these over so that you guys will see what's going to be coming, and I'll be building them what you can get. I don't get anything different than what you can get. I just get it a little bit earlier. So we got the Foxy Box, the Chevy custom van coming out, 1/25th scale, sweet accessories, custom grill. I love that massive bow tie grill. We got skylights. We got louvered portals. You got to have louvered on the Chevy because you got so many babes in the back. You don't want anybody peeping in. The van's a rockin'. Don't come a knockin'. We've got the sweet Chevy 2 427 powered funny car. I like building dragsters because you can go any direction you want to go with them, from perfection builds to fun builds to fantasy and anything you want. So this one will be fun build, of course, 1/25th scale. We've got the tubbed chassis. We've got velocity stacks, drag racing style. We've got pre-built headers for you. Everything on the back of the box you can see. You can always pause these and check them out to see what's on there. A kit I knew existed, but I didn't think I'd ever see as a release and get to build. The Super Snow Sport by Rupp, the world's first dragster snowmobile. This is in 1/20th scale, so it's going to be a big kit. It looks a little complicated because it's got multiple pieces. It's got a very thin frame on it. It's got a giant honking V8 right in front of the driver's seat. There's a real-world picture of it. You can check it out on there. On the side, tells you everything that's under the hood. It's got a 302 to push this little drag snowmobile. And you can see the parts are quite fine. It's got the nice large body and then the real skinny chassis. We've got treads, black vinyl treads for those snowmobile tracks. Definitely got to get that built up in the month of February while it's still winter out. Then we've got this sweet Chevy Corvette custom kit. 1968 Corvette. Very interesting. They're kind of pushing some of these out this year, these interesting, uniquely designed kits that the folks loved from the custom days. Check out all the stuff that's in that box. all those custom parts. Paul will get that the ring light on there. It tends to reflect off that plastic. But yeah, so many cool parts on that thing. We've got our Stingray body. All one shell. We got that awesome hood on there. I don't think it can be billed as a custom or as a stock Corvette. I don't think so. But I haven't torn it open yet. So with the review, I will let you know if it can or cannot be. And Star Trek stuff. I love Star Trek stuff. I don't build a lot of it on the show. I usually do just like a quick build of it. This one's going to be getting a full build because this is a very special kit to me. I've seen this around forever. I know it's been reissued a while ago. Now they've reissued it. You can do the entire Enterprise bridge set. All the instrumentation includes all the figures and more. Includes decals to build it all the way around. You can do the full circular bridge, the command module, and 10 different figures in the kit so that you can complement the entire bridge crew and more. So you've got that, you're not going to be missing Uhura, you're not going to be missing Chekhov. You're going to get all the main characters and a couple floaters around that you can make all red shirts and have them end up dead. But you can see how nicely that's going to look when we're all done. It's probably not going to be as nice as this person, the person that built it for the box art, because I'm not that good of a figure painter, but we're going to have a good time. We're going to get to build up a Star Trek bridge and enjoy ourselves. The last two that I've got in for the video, Monte Carlo Super Stalker. You've seen me build these. It's got those giant Goodyear tires in it. The sweet decal sheet. I know it drives you nuts when I say decal. Some of you, the ones without any sense of humor. Monte Carlo Super Stalker from the Super Stalker series. Now, I've built a few of these. I've only done one kind of roached out. I think this Monte here is due to be roached out. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. I think it's time to beat another one up. You can see we got those giant pad-printed Goodyears. We got the roll cage. We got the headers. We got that nice, big, honking Monte Carlo body. Yeah. Next up, I don't know anything about this kit. I don't know anything. I've never heard of it. I've never seen it. So when the box showed up at my house, I am at a complete loss as to what this is. It's called the Californian, a swinging luxury sports car. Look at that. That is unique. I just saw the movie Night Shift, and it kind of looks like the Chrysler Cordoba, but it's got a fastback. It's got this weird, like, split wing from a Superbird, but cut down the middle. I don't know anything about this car. I really don't. West Coast body design with features of the cars to come. What is this thing? Somebody tell me in the comments. You guys know what it is. I'm sure the experts out there. A front-wheel drive engine. Is that a Buick Riviera? I don't know. It looks really cool to me, and that's what I like about model building. I get to build this thing, and I don't know anything about it, and it doesn't matter because I'm going to have a good time. So, while you're figuring out what that is, I'm going to reset for the next and final sponsor of the video, and I'll be right back. And now, the end of the video comes upon us, and we've got the offerings from Revell and Revell Germany for this month's new kit video. Right up in front, the matching set, the Porsche 911 Carrera 3.2s, Targa, and Coupe. ModelRoundup.com is getting these in extremely soon. They might even have them in by the time this video airs on Saturday morning. I know they're getting them in. It's all new tooling, 1/24th scale for both of them in the Revell USA boxings. We've got that sweet, sweet Targa top, Porsche 911. I really, really like that. That classic red with the black interior is my favorite look on the Porsches. And for you non-convertible enjoyment style types, we've got the coupe, the hard top. And this one is molded, at least it might be. I know the German offering is molded in silver. I shouldn't say this one is, because it is the USA offering, and they know that USA modelers like white. So I guess what we'll have to do is, no matter which one I decide to build in a video, we'll build one, we'll unbox the other one in the same video, and then you'll be able to see everything and the differences between the two. But I'm excited for those. I love the Porsche kits. They are so much fun. For the military folks out there and the ship folks out there, we've got the U.S. Navy Swift Boat Mark I, 1/72 scale, 93 parts, Revell, Germany. That is a very sharp-looking model ship. We can see on there it is 8 inches long, 93 parts, molded in a light gray. And on the back, check that out. One-piece bottom hull, upper deck, so it should be quite easy to assemble. We might have to get a ship model on the show. We haven't done one in a very, very long time. In 1/24 scale, Revell USA reissues the 1956 Ford Thunderbird, which is nice because the 57 Thunderbird gets a lot of attention. The 56 doesn't get as much. I built this when I was a kid. I know I did. At least I'm pretty sure. It was molded in red, and I didn't have to paint anything, and it looked horrible, but I didn't care because I was like 10, and I just enjoyed gluing it together with the giant tube glue. So this one is 7.5 inches long, 87 parts, 1/24 scale for this one. And Model Roundup will be carrying that as well. We've got the big honking 1/25 scale, skill level 5, Revell Germany boxing of the Peterbilt 359. This one's got all the cool stuff in the sleeper. It's got the lift-off roof so you can look down inside unless you want to glue it together. It's got the air dam on there. It is a beautiful truck. I love the box art because it's very reminiscent of the Jimmy from Smokey the Bandit 2. Of course, it's a Peterbilt, so it's not, but it's very reminiscent. 302 parts, almost 13 inches long. My box came pre-opened for me, but the detail in there on that, is that a Caterpillar engine? Painted that color. We got that open sleeper. Check that out. We got that open sleeper in the back. Full tilting nose, radiator, duals and all that. This is an extensive kit. I heard it's a little bit of a challenge to assemble, so I guess we're going to be finding out on the show. And finally, the last kit for the month. I never thought I'd see one, and my cool peeps at Revell USA went on the line for me and got me a copy of the Revell Germany Mandalorian Razor Crest in 1/72 scale. 101 parts, 33 centimeters long. It's like that big. Big model ship. Mandalorian is a huge show if you're into sci-fi, which I am, and I'm big into Star Wars. I can't wait to start working on this thing. It's got a full cockpit in it. It's got the Mandalorian himself. We're going to get to use our metallic spray paints to detail that thing up. It's going to be so cool. It's going to be so cool. And then what I get to do by building this one up is that later this year, when the AMT Razor Crest comes out and I get that one, we can do a side-by-side comparison. So these are available. You can get these off of eBay and other people that'll ship them in the United States. They're not for sale in the United States per se, but you can get a hold of them and shipped here. So wanted to get this on there. I'm so excited about this. I'm excited about all the plastic kits. As always, we thank our channel sponsors for being so cool and kind to send over everything, knowing that not everything can get a full build, but they want you to know what's coming out so that you can enjoy model kits and see what's all going to be upcoming on the show. I thank you all. I will have a slideshow at the end of all the new box art that's coming out, and we will see all of you at the next full build review.